Hi, I'm Francois Turcotte, SMP Product Manager at Eaton Energy Automation Solutions. In this video, we'll learn how to configure an SMP platform for the first time and about the different tools available with the SMP Tools software. First, ensure that you have unserved rights before starting the installation. If you are doing the installation with the ISO file and your operating system is Windows 10, you can just mount it directly in the operating system. If you're using a different operating system, you'll need a specific software to mount it. When the ISO file is mounted, you can then open the HTML page that allows you to navigate through the ISO file. Select the language and follow the link to install the SMP Tools suite. At the end of the installation, you'll need to install either the full version or only the version pack. The complete version is used to install the full version, including the version pack. The version pack only is used to install only the necessary configuration pack on your PC. This option is very helpful if you need to manage multiple firmware versions on a single computer. We can now start SMP Manager by clicking on the icon on the desktop or the start menu. If we now connect the USB cable on the console port on the SMP, the status will appear in SMP Manager. Now that we are connected, we can obtain a lot of information from our SMP, such as the firmware version and the SMP model. By right-clicking on the USB entry in SMP Manager, we get a list of different tools available with our SMP, such as SMP Config, SMP Stats, SMP Trace, SMP Logs, and many more. We also have two very useful menu options called Get Configuration File and Send Configuration File. These two options are necessary to obtain configuration from the SMP or to push a configuration onto the platform. The configuration file extension is .par or a .par file. We will now open the tool SMP Config. Here's what it looks like. This tool is used to configure the SMP platform, and it is where you can add a master and a slave instance, configure the firewall, and many more options. We also have the tool SMP Log that keeps a log of all events on the system. This log is stored on the SMP, and it can only be viewed by an authorized user. Now, the SMP Stats tool allows the user to see the status of different components in real time, including the master connection status and the time synchronization status. You can also see whether or not a control center is connected. These status points are not stored on the SMP, so they are only available in real time. Now let's see how we configure the SMP network address. We simply need to go to the SMP device menu and configure network settings. We now decide on which port we want to change the configuration. So now enter the entire network configuration and click OK. A fast reboot will then occur, which will reconfigure the platform. When the reboot is complete, you can now decide to communicate with the SMP using the network interface instead of USB. Simply add a new SMP entry in the list by clicking on the plus sign icon in the toolbar. Enter the name of the SMP, and then go in the first IP address and type the IP address that we set in the previous step. We see the status appearing after a few seconds, and we are now ready to communicate. We can now disconnect the USB cable and access remotely through the network or SMP. We can also display other options from this menu, like the IP address or the serial number. Right-clicking on any of the top column header will display this menu. Ethan and I would like to thank you for watching this short video. Please don't hesitate to reach out to our customer support for more information. That email address is located at the end of this document. Thank you, everyone.